And welcome to the how-to demo scene or stuff. I'm Saga Musix, and I'm going to tell you a few things that might be interesting, especially for the people who have never been to a demo party before, and also some interesting things that might be interesting if you are planning to get involved in some way or another. Like, if you think you want to make a demo, but you have no idea where to start, then you will find some interesting facts in this seminar, hopefully. So the newbie program that we have at Revision that some of you agreed to participate in is basically we have the seminar and we have the mentors that will also help you outside the seminar. So we are going to introduce ourselves to you later, and then you can, whenever you see us at the party, you can ask us, or you can go to the info desk and tell them that you need help from a mentor, and then they will call us to the info desk, and then we will meet with you to help you with whatever problems you have. But hopefully most of the problems will already be solved in this seminar. And to start with that, we will show you the intranet, which is a very important part of the party and of many other demo parties as well. So the intranet is the intranet is located at local.revisionparty.net. This should also be printed somewhere on the leaflets that you got in the back when you bought your ticket. And it's also written in the voting key. You got this in your goodie bag. This is a voting key. And this allows you to vote, to upload your demos or graphics or music or whatever you brought to Revision. So here you see the intranet. Yeah, you should register first. So, oh, you have your own voting.
Yeah, yeah,
okay. So we don't even need that one. So when you register, yes?
Hello, microphone. If I registered on the website before I came here, am I already registered?
No, that's different. So on the Revision website, you basically just indicated that you will be attending. And this is your account for voting and submitting productions. So FGenesis currently signs up with his vote key that you can find inside here. Yes? Anyway, there is also a QR code in there, so if you have some fancy device that can scan QR codes, you can sign up through this code without having to enter like the URL and the vote key and everything. So now we are in the intranet, and like you can see some interesting things here, like the one-liner, which is just stupid things that people write, and you can add your own stupid stuff there. Down there you can see a list of upcoming events, and yeah, now there's even more stupid stuff on the one-liner. And then there's also some more interesting stuff. Yeah, our seminar is not visible anymore because it's already running, but there are interesting things like upload your competition entries. So if you brought, like, I don't know, a picture for the graphics compo.
I need to
He's already signed up, but he's asking if he wants, if he needs to sign up again.
Tu dois uploader ton entrée.
Somebody else did it for him.
That's an interesting question.
Maybe, are you asking if this key only works once, okay? So don't waste it.
Yes.
And don't give it to other people.
Yeah, you should keep this to yourself, please. Next time you know it. So, we decided to upload an entry, so maybe some of you already brought an entry, graphics, music, maybe even a demo. So, as you can see, there are quite a few competitions at Revision, since that's what we are here for. And you select the competition in which you want to participate in, for example, click one, track music. And then you have various fields that are mostly self-explanatory, like the title is what should be shown on the big screen as the name for your production. The author, a very helpful hint here is that if you submit something for a group, so if it's not just you who work on this production, then please put the group name there and remove your own name. Otherwise, it looks like, oh, this one person did all of this. Wow, that's great. You have the author field here, and like by default, this just fills in your handle that you used for registration, but you can also remove it and then put your group name in, Poop Rain, for example. Or
it's just a random example.
Yes, very absolutely random. Correct. Then there is a description field. This will also be shown on the big screen. So there you can write some technical stuff, like I used Photoshop and a camera and a Wacom tablet, or I used Renoise for making my music or something like that. So this will be shown on the big screen. The message on the, to the organizers won't be shown on the big screen. This is like, for example, if you have a demo with special requirements or you are not quite sure about anything, then you write it in the message to the organizers so that they will read it before your entry is shown. And the running time is obviously only required for entries that have a running time. So for example, not still pictures, but demos or music or whatever. And then there are some competition options. They depend on which competition you take place in. So for example, in the tracked music compo, you have these options. You won't have them in other competitions because they are not relevant. So it's mostly self-explanatory. And if not, you can always leave these empty, like they are not required to be filled in, or you can ask someone what should be filled in there. Then the most important part here is to upload your actual entry. So this should be a single file. So you just, if your entry consists of more than one file, you put it into a zip file or whatever and then upload it there. Then there's some personal data that you have to fill in. And for music entries, there's also the composer data, which is most of the time the same thing. So you can just copy it. And then if you scroll down even further, you have to click a checkbox and then save it. Yes, please.
If you're in a group and you have like a group entry, who writes their address?
Anyone. It's just for organizational matters, I think.
Okay.
So it's just some person that participated. For the composer data, it's obviously relevant that the musician's name is put in there. Yeah, for the other stuff, it's just some person of the group.
Some person, some address.
Yeah, whoever submits it.
But it should be said, these data are not collected for fun or so. Yes. It's for the GEMA, because they want this to make see who of their musicians is registered with them. So that's just an organizational issue, unfortunately.
Yeah, music-wise,
but
I get it. Yeah,
someone else can explain this better than I can.
Yeah, I think the other...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like because you may win a prize and then like legally the organizers are required to like write down who got the money and stuff. So it's like nobody is going to sell this data on the black market or whatever, so don't worry about it. So yeah, if we had some entry right now, we could hit the save button. From there on, like it will tell you, yeah, the entry has been uploaded, or maybe there has been an issue. So that's, I think that's obvious. So there are other things that you can also do in the intranet. So we all, yes?
One thing that is very, very important that everyone or kind of half the people forget every year, if your entry is something that is not music, I obviously picked a bad example here, sorry for that. If it is anything visual, upload a thumbnail of it. There will be an option to upload a thumbnail. People keep forgetting this, but because there's so much sensory input over the next 2 days, you'll see this, people will not be able to associate your entry with just when they're just given the name of it. They will forget it, unfortunately. Yes. So if you can upload a screenshot, do it. Yes. Do not forget this. This is extremely important.
Yeah, for any other competitions apart from music competitions, there's an extra upload field for a screenshot. So please don't leave that empty. So other stuff that you can do in the internet, you can see who has already signed up. So maybe you can spot your friends in this list. So this is the list of people who registered with their vote key, not the list of people who registered on the website in advance. Then you can also click on the photo wall. You maybe have already seen the photo wall. It's at the entrance area, and you can take silly pictures of yourself and your friends there and download them and, I don't know, show them to your parents to show how great this event is or whatever. Yeah, very nice. Then there is also the complete timetable. This might be very important because the printed timetable on the leaflet might become out of date because some competitions are sometimes shifted around or some event is canceled or whatever. So here you can always see what will be happening today. The next important thing is voting. So after we all have submitted our great entries, they are played during a competition, and then you can vote on them. This is a very important aspect of demo parties. You, everyone, the crowd, are the people who decide who is going to be the winner. It's not some kind of jury or whatever. So during the competitions, you can live vote, either using the Revision app, which you can download in the app stores, or through your web browser with the live voting interface. So when the competition starts, you will see a URL that will tell you where the live voting is happening. Or if you missed the compo, you can always go to this site, and after the compo, you can still vote or adjust your votes that you made while you were completely drunk or whatever. And so there is, I think it's like a, you can give 1 to 5 stars for each entry, and obviously like the best entry gets 5 stars. And yes, please do this because it's important.
You can vote on more than one entry with 5 stars. So
yes.
It's not, you need to pick one entry.
And a thing I personally never really understood is you can give up to 5 stars, but what happens if you do not give any star?
That's 0 stars.
That's 0 stars. So I don't know how you see this, but there are some categories where I have no idea about, say music. I'm not a musical person, so I decide for myself not to vote there. So if you want to be fair, then you can say I either vote on all entries in a category or I vote on none of them. So because if you vote for a single one, that gets all the stars, and then the others get 0. Yeah. So it depends on, it's just added up as a sum.
How can you not be into music?
Well,
that's fine. Well, if it makes you dance, it's 5 stars.
What do you mean by dance? you mean move in,
like
interesting.
You wiggle.
Anyway, so yeah, whatever way you vote is obviously up to you, but please don't think that just because it's your first time or because you have like no idea what is going on there, I won't be voting. This is...
Do vote.
Yes.
If you do not vote, Trump will become president.
can someone talk to that guy?
So another thing that you can do after the first competitions have run is check out the releases. which might, of course, be important for voting. So there are no releases yet, unfortunately. But yeah, that's where you can download your favorite graphics entry or music entry or whatever before like the party ends, so that you can listen to it on your way home or whatever. And yeah, I think that's the most important parts of the intranet. So we will move on to some online resources which might already be interesting during the party or when you get home and you decide that you absolutely have to make a demo now. So the first one is ID. Go to id.scene.org. This is kind of a meta site that you will need for accessing or like registering on various other sites. So Scene ID is basically a single sign-on for various demo scene websites. So you may know Poet or Puet or whatever you may want to pronounce it. Poet, also interesting. So for example, that website uses Scene ID. So you just register here once and then you can access various other demo scene websites. I think there's actually a list somewhere. Yeah, there's a variety of demo scene related websites. Oh yeah, you can also log in there, yes. This one, yes. So this is a list of websites where you can log in with this Scene ID. So another website would be, for example, DemoZoo, or you can bounce off, yes. Or you can go to various other websites and like you just create one login and then you can post on these websites. We will come back to some of them in a bit. So the next thing we want to show is scene.org without the ID dot in the front. So this is basically the main demo scene archive. This is a really large file archive that contains the releases from hundreds of demo parties or also demos that have been released outside of demo parties. And so this is basically where you can find everything from 1987 to 2017. And that's just the parties. So you can find even older stuff in the other folders. So, for example, if you want to check out how were the music composed at Revision last year, you just go to 2016 and then Revision 16, and then you have all the files there. And after Revision has ended this year, you will also find this year's files on there. So, if you need like inspiration, for example, you want to watch some demos, you can find them there. But of course, this is not the best way to figure out like what demo should I watch. So there is curio.scene.org, which is a curated list of really nice demos. You can also reach it right from the scene.org front page, right there. So if you have no idea which demo you want to watch, maybe check out one of these because they are really good. And yeah, that's basically what Curio does. Nothing more, nothing less. I think there are links to the actual executables. It leads you to... All right, maybe a bit more than that. Yeah, it has a download and a nice description. Well, there are also other sites where you can easily find the video captures of many demos. So the next site we are going to visit is demozoo.org. It's a zoo of demos, as the name says. DemoZoo is basically like a front end to scene.org. Like here you can search for all the graphics and music and demos, and you will find not only the download link, but also links to video captures or comments from other people. Or like you find extra information like what is the soundtrack for this demo and where can I download it? Stuff like that. So for example, if you search for a random demo, search for the popular demo, for example. So you will find the demo over there. Yes. No, that one, yes. And you will see screenshots, you will see a download location, you will see a YouTube link, and you see the soundtrack, and you see who actually worked on the demo, and other interesting stuff. And as we already mentioned, you can log into this site with your scene ID and then write a comment on a demo, for example. There is another similar site, which is linked right here, which we already talked about, where nobody knows how to pronounce it. Pouet. Yeah, I think that's the official French pronunciation, but since most sceners are not French, they kind of make up their own pronunciation. By the way, it's the sound of a trumpet. And that's why there are trumpets in the background. So now we are on Pouet and see the same demo once again with many comments from other people there, or links to videos and stuff like that. So someone didn't like the demo. So yeah, there are some weird comments every now and then. Just ignore them. That's how people are. But Pouet is more than that. There is also a discussion board where you can ask questions, for example, getting started in the scene. Maybe we should post there that this person should attend the seminar. Or maybe is this person even here in the room? Doesn't seem like it. So yeah, there's you can watch productions, you can write in the forum, and many other things. And what will you do if you decided now, I have watched so many demos, and I want to make my own demo, but who is going to make the music, or who is going to make the graphics? Like, I can't draw. So then you go to wanted.scene.org. This is basically a page where you can say, I am looking for a musician, or a graphician, or a coder. Or you can offer your help. Like you say, I can draw, or I can make 3D models, and I want to work on a demo. And then like, if someone happens to need your skills, then they can contact you through that website. And like you see, there are quite a few open requests. So maybe read through them, and you will see that, yeah, sadly, some of them haven't been like fulfilled yet. But maybe read through them and you find something interesting that you would like to work on. And then you can simply contact that person.
Are there people that need help right now?
Yeah, these are, I think there are also a few people seeking for help. But right now, yeah, like there you see needs help. And you will often see that these requests like spring up right before some demo party, and they will no longer be seen once the request has been like answered or closed. So right now you just see the open requests there. So yeah, I would definitely recommend having a look at that site, entering your own requests or your own offers there, or seek for other people that may want to collaborate with you. And next up, maybe you want to see what these people who want to work with you actually look like. And there is the demo scene's own picture website for that called Slangtang. And this is a website with many pictures from demo party. There will also be pictures of revision. And yeah, it's let's say the web design is a bit outdated, but that is being worked on. since a few years, but anyway, yeah, this is a fun website where you can also look like, what does a certain demo party look like? Like, I want to go to Evoke, I have never been there, and I want to see what Evoke looks like. Yes, Evoke is cool, go there. Here you could, for example, see what Evoke looks like, and you would see that last year there was a bouncy castle at Evoke. Maybe that motivates you to go to Evoke this year as well. Although I cannot promise that there will be a bouncy castle. Sadly not. Yes, on this website you can also use Scene ID to log in, and you can comment on funny pictures or fill in your profile and stuff like that. And also,
if you want to see pictures of sceners, you can find them there. So if you don't know how Defox looks like, you can find pictures there.
Yeah, there's a search function where you can search for nicknames, and then yeah.
I cannot read it from here, but yeah.
to the right. Yes, that one. And if you don't know what the main organizer of this demo party looks like, you search for DFox. I think without the dot R you can find it. And then you can click on one of the thumbnails, and then you see DFox and Oki. Anyway, there are two more websites that we want to mention quickly. And these are demo scene radios. So there's a lot of music being produced in the demo scene. And there is, for example, SceneSet, which streams demo scene related music all day long. And there is a list of tunes that have been played or are going to be played. You can listen to it in your favorite media player, or I think there's also an online player. I don't think we have to demonstrate that. And last but not least, I mean, there are several demo scene radios, but another one that you can look into is scenemusic.net, also called Nectarine Radio. And so this one also has a lot of demo scene related music. So if you want to listen to some chip tunes or music from demos and stuff like that, you can do it here. Oh, there's one more resource which is a bit meta, we can say, because it shows you where to find other information. And that resource is called howto.planetd.net. It has a wiki, and in this wiki you can find, sources link, you can find many resources that will teach you, for example, how to do graphics programming and stuff like that. So if you don't know where to get started on demo making, this website has a lot of material that you can go through, and hopefully that would get you started. And if you still have questions afterwards, you can, for example, go to Puet and ask your question there. Or you can come on IRC, Internet Relay Chat, and chat with many other demo sceners. So some of you are probably already familiar with IRC. For other people, so IRC is basically text-based chat. And for example, there is an IRC channel dedicated to the revision party. And this is seen right here. So these are demo sceners talking interesting stuff. And you can either connect there through your favorite IRC client. The revision channel is located on IRCnet. Or you can use, if you just want to get familiar with IRC, you can use the Mibit web client, which you have just seen. If you can go back to the browser. And if you go to that website, mibit.com, you can open the chat there and select IRCnet from the drop-down list of networks, and then enter the channel name Revision or the New Sceners channel. And we will also have this information handy at the newbie desk so that you don't have to write this down and have some typos in it or whatever. So here you have a list of many IRC networks, but we are located on IRCnet. And yeah, you have to pick a nickname to join. Yeah, something like that. And then you forgot to enter the channels. And then you can join, for example, the revision channel or the new sceners channel, which we have created specifically to answer questions from all the newbies. And that's one way to get in touch with us if you have any more questions. Right, now we will do a short introduction with all the mentors shortly explaining who they are, what they do in the scene, how they got into the scene, and we don't have time to let everyone in this room introduce themselves, but like if anyone is eager to introduce themselves, for example, because you are looking for some mates to make a demo with, then you are welcome to also introduce yourself later. Or you can do it on IRC, as we just have shown, or you can do it at the newbie table, or you can just walk around in the hall. Demo sceners are friendly people, and if you see someone doing something interesting, then don't hesitate to like just ask them, what are you doing? Or this looks cool, can you explain how you have done it? Or stuff like that. Most people will be happy to answer you, and many new friendships will probably also arise that way. So yes, I think we'll start. Yes? The question?
Can you please repeat the name of this how-to website?
howto.planet-d.net. Okay, it is probably a bit too small to read, but we will have a list of... As said, we will have the information also handy at the newbie table on a piece of paper so that you can copy the links from there. So yeah, if there are no more questions right now, we will start with the introduction round. So I will start, and we don't need the mic just yet. So as I've already said in the beginning, my nickname is Saga Musix. I have joined the demo scene a while ago. So I started programming 15 years ago. Actually, next week it will be my anniversary, so to speak. And I started writing stupid games on MS-DOS back then. It was not really scene related, but I always wanted to get some nice music into these games. And then eventually I discovered some programs which basically were invented in the demo scene. They're called trackers. They are a very, let's say, a technical way to create music, and I ended up downloading one of them and then found out that these are somehow related to something called demos, and apparently these demos are graphical demonstrations of some sort, and then I got somehow hooked into this, and that's why I am here today. And yeah, apart from making music, I also program one of these trackers. It's called OpenMPT, so whoever of you is into track music might have heard of that before. It's one of the most widespread modern trackers at the moment. And so if you have a question about that, you can also ask me. Or if you have a question about making music for demos, you can also ask me. I personally am not really a demo coder, so I'm maybe not the best person to ask about that. But maybe I can redirect you to other people who know better. For example, someone here, I don't know. So next person who wants to introduce themselves.
If I have to.
Yeah. You have to. Well, you have said well, so much stupid stuff already, you can say some more.
All right. So my nick is Evgenesis. I found the scene, I don't know how many years ago, possibly I was 14 or so, so half a lifetime ago. By some unethical means, I somehow found GTA San Andreas online somewhere, and it had a little 64 kilobyte .exe file next to it. And since I was young and I had no idea what I was doing, I just started this, and instead of infecting my machine, which would probably happen today, I found a Cracktro that was 64 kilobytes, and it had music and sound and graphics, and I wondered how it fit in there. And it didn't run well on my box back then because it was bad and old, but this somehow sparked my interest, and a bit later I found various small size intros. I think the first ones were Conspiracy, and eventually I met the people on IRC many years later in 2013, and when Gargai eventually convinced me, just come to revision, dude, you live in Saarbrücken, just do it. And so I did, and since then I've been at pretty much every revision, and yeah, other demo parties, and got to know various people, and if you want to know people, he knows everyone. Yeah, so just ask him, don't ask me, ask him. What I do, well, I'm coder pretty much, so I said before, I have no idea about music. And graphics are pretty bad too, so I can draw lines. But drawing lines in code is better than just moving your hand, because why would you move your hand to do that? Yeah, and I don't know, anyone else? Or questions, or?
Cracks.
Hi. So my name is Ragnarok. I joined the scene in, oh, let me think, must have been like 97 or 98. And how did I come to there? I used to have an Amiga, and the you will hear that a lot.
Yes, if someone shouts Amiga in the main hall, just join them. It's okay.
Yeah, just join. It's fun. So, and the Amiga scene has always been very influenced by the demo scene. So it was kind of natural for me to like to just fall into there, and I mainly do graphics, and I joined a very controversial group at the time, it was called Metallfotze, which would loosely translate to metal cunt. And yeah, we did bad things at parties. And well, back then in the 90s, parties were like about partying hard. And when you look at pictures from the time, you will see what I mean. And later on, they acquired us to do the organizing, so that now I'm one of the good guys. So yeah, if you have any questions, ask me.
My turn now. My nickname is Nerdin, and I'm one of the few girls in the scene. There are more, I see some here, so that's great. Finally, there are parties where we're like maybe 10 only. So please, more. I got to the scene because of this guy. Revision was my first party in 2011, so I'm pretty new. And yeah, I'm doing graphics. So when I was apprentice in media design together with him, he found out about me digging computers, so he was like, yeah, you definitely have to come to this Easter party. And was like, what the hell are you talking about? Yeah, it's this, you know, getting together. I'm like, is it about playing games? No, not at all. Okay, what is it about? Yeah, it's about computer, just come. And yeah, so yeah, I was there and I loved it, so I stayed. So until, yeah, since 2011, I have been to a lot of parties. I also organized one of the Norwegian parties because I live in Norway now. I'm German, but I live in Norway. And yeah, that's more or less what I'm doing, but still pretty new to the scene, not like him. So,
6 years.
Yeah, but I mean, these guys started when they were 14, and yeah. So, yeah, of course. Of course. Yeah. So maybe to another guy who's a little bit older than me, a little longer in the scene.
No, I'm not new,
but compared to the other people here, I'm pretty new.
Not so new anymore. But now, as she already told, I'm a bit more not so old fart, but well, MTS. I'm coding on IBM PC since the mid of the 80s, and it took me only 10 years to find out there's something called demo scene, thanks to the bulletin boards that you dial up late at night because it was cheap with a phone. And like, and initially, I started with Discmax, digital magazines, got a bit rare nowadays with all the internet, but back then, swapping them on disk was quite hot shit. My task is mainly coding, especially size coding, small intros, 265 bytes, 4K, 8K, delivering every Easter a new release, torturing your brains and ears. I'm also sometimes doing graphics. I'm part of Scoopex and Alcatraz, also have a fun project called Wursttope. And since about 4 years, I'm also part of a Nordlicht organizing team, a smaller demo party in the north of Germany. And so if you have any question about coding on newer platforms or also how to approach stuff, how to do stuff, well, just feel free to ask me whenever you see me. So, last one.
I think it's my turn. I'm Lambdacore, Jan from Cologne area. I'm in the scene since late 90-ish somehow. My first demo party was Evoke 2004, and I'm a Evoke organizer for 5-6 years now. And at Revision, it's my second time as an organizer. I'm not a creative person at all. What I do is I can fix stuff, I build networks, and I'm here for any questions regarding everything which I can know. So, yeah.
Yay!
Yay!
So, yeah. That's us, but what about you? Like, if anyone wants to introduce themselves and, like, for example, say that they are interested in making a demo, but they are still looking for a musician or whatever, maybe now is the time to speak up. Anyone? You can do it.
Hi, I want to build something with LEDs. That part I can do. The art part I can't do. Awesome.
It's young. You can do that. Come to our table. It's called the IGAD table, but it's actually poo brain table. So you can just go there, and there's this guy with a machine built with LEDs. It's pretty much. Are you sure you're not connected to this guy yet? Oh, okay. That's
fine. Let's see. This is how it works.
All right. So, hi, I'm Beth Dex, Steph, natural name. I came into the demo scene because my friend kept bothering me that I had to come along, and for years, and me and my boyfriend didn't know what it was, and then he started coding. He's actually a coder. I don't do that much. I did pixel art for Tsuck, who was there, knew it was pretty bad, but I did it, and I find the scene very inspiring and very friendly, extremely friendly, and very nice. So, yeah, so that's it. So thank you for being so sweet and so awesome, and so open-minded. So yeah, if you need something with LEDs, I know a guy.
Anyone else who needs LEDs or coders or musicians or crafticians? Yes, one more.
Hi, I'm interested in finding other people who are interested in doing something with the Rust programming language?
Oh, there are definitely some people around.
Yeah.
So maybe you have heard of Ferris?
Yeah, I know. I messaged him on Reddit, and he messaged me back, so I'm happy about that.
Yeah, and I think he should know a few more people as well. And maybe there are a few more around at the party. I personally am not a Rust programmer, so I cannot help there. I can just forward you to other people.
Okay, so I'm...
Or anyone in the crowd who programs Rust? Okay. Anyone else? Um, You have to do it like in a hidden way.
Like you just did.
Yes. Okay.
Hello, I'm from Russia, and I love demo scene. I've been on Chaos Construction a couple of times. It's a great party in St. Petersburg, Russia. I love everything around scene, but I'm too lazy to code. So I'm just going to hang around, look at other people works and maybe cry. So it's all. Thank you.
Okay. Okay, one more person.
Hi. Personally, it's my first demo party, and I think I first heard of demo scene like 5 or 6 years ago when also downloading some video games or whatever. and right now I'm came here alone and I'm searching for people to maybe make a demo this weekend. And so I can code, I can do graphics, in music I'm quite bad, but I can bit do it. I never released something, but I've already tried to make some demo toys, like hanging on Shadow Toy and doing some demos as standalone shaders and stuff like this. So yeah, that's it.
Okay, nice. So I would suggest that we end the introduction round here. One more thing that might be interesting for all of you, we also have this behind the scenes tour. The first one will start tomorrow and you will learn there how certain parts of the demo party work. Like how do the organizers, for example, like do all the magic to show the stuff on the big screen and on the big speakers and stuff like that. So you can find the behind the scenes tours on the timetable, on the intranet and also on the leaflet. And you simply go there and then you can learn how revision basically works. And last but not least, what we are going to do now is a short tour through the party place.
Yeah?
But maybe the opening will be delayed, like any device. That's a good.
The opening will be late.
Yes, that's rule number one of demo parties. Everything is delayed. Nothing is on time. Okay. Right now it's 3:57. So in theory, the opening ceremony should start in 3 minutes. But it might be delayed, so he's going to find out if this is going to be the case. So either if the opening ceremony is about to start, we will watch it together, we will just gather at the stage, and then do the party tour afterwards, or if there's enough time left, we can also do it right now. So the party tour is basically, we will show you all the interesting places right here at the party place that you might not have found yet. For example, if you don't have a hotel room, you may want to sleep at the party place. There is an area behind the big screen where you can set up your sleeping mattress. Okay, yeah. It gets full very quickly, so for next year you already know that you should reserve a place there as quickly as possible. But you can also sleep under the table. It's a classic at demo parties. And stuff like that. Then, I mean, the main hall, I think you have already seen it. It's pretty big. There are hundreds of demo sceners in there that you can talk to, including yourself. There is the big screen in front. This is where all the competitions will be run. And so I really advise that for the competitions, you come in front. There are like the stairs that you can sit on, because watching the competitions right in front of the big screen is at least 1,000 times more awesome than watching it from your place in front of your laptop.
Dude, especially with the 64K.
Yes, there are some very... There will be some very tense competitions where you will be like, wow, can the next entry be even better?
Yes, because it's 64K.
And yes, there have been some rumors that the 64K competition will be very good this year. So reserve a seat in front of the big screen before that competition, and also before of all the other competitions, of course. And as I said, it's much nicer to be right in front of the big audio system and have like the full screen in like your complete field of vision and everything, instead of sitting like back at the party hall and like seeing it. Okay, so the opening is on time, so we will talk a bit more until the opening starts, and then afterwards we will do the guided tour. Yeah, we will need to build.
Regarding sleeping, if you haven't, you can get free earplugs at the info desk. So you will need those to sleep.
Not only to sleep.
Also, if it's loud during a compo, you also want those. And for sleeping, there will be noise 24/7 24 hours a day. So just get those earplugs.
Free earplugs at the info desk. Get them. So free. Yeah. Before you leave, please. We are quite a big group, and we just meet here again, and then we will do it. So yeah, we will split the group into three smaller groups, and then we have two of the mentors each guiding you through the party place. Yes, exactly. After the opening, you come here. Thank you.